So for the second question, the first question was done. For the second question, we have to prove that a minus b power n is equal to a power n into 1 minus n, and then b upon a minus b plus n into n plus 1 upon 2 factorial, b upon a minus b squared, and so on. That's kind of weird. Okay. So how do we get that a minus b over there? So if I take the reciprocal, maybe that will work. So if I take the reciprocal, it's going to be 1 upon a minus b, something like that. And that thing is the negative 1 power. But that doesn't make sense. How can we get b upon a minus b? So how can we do that thing? What about we try adding? Oh, yes, obviously, that's going to work. That is, in fact, going to work. So yeah, that might be nice. Yeah, so let's consider the following. So this guy, a minus b to the power of n, this can be written as like 1 upon a minus b to the power of negative n. And then maybe I can write it as, I think, yeah, that could be nice. So yeah, let's multiply by a power negative n over there. Shit. No, wait a second. Yes, let's do that. So this will be like a upon a minus b to the power of negative n. And because you multiply by a power negative n, you have to divide by a power negative n, which is the same thing as multiplying by a power positive n. So over here, you will have a power positive n, which actually matches with this term over there. Okay, and now what? Now let's see if I can kind of change this somehow. What would happen if I add b to that? Yeah, then I will get b upon a minus b over there. So hey, that could work. That might actually work. Okay, so let's do this. So what is this? This is actually like 1 plus b upon a minus b, right? Because a minus b plus b, that's actually just a, so a upon a minus b. Yeah, that's definitely going to work. And this is to the negative n power, and yeah, that actually turns out to be this series. So just using the general binomial theorem, you can see it completely matches. So you just have 1, then minus n into b upon a minus b, then plus because you got like minus n and then minus n minus 1, so it's plus n into n plus 1 upon 2 factorial, and then b upon a minus b squared, and then you will have minus n minus n minus 1 minus n minus 2. So it's going to be an alternate plus or minus. And because we are decreasing in the negative direction, it's like we are increasing the magnitude. So it's going to be like minus into n plus 1 and then negative of n plus 2 and so on. So we will be adding these terms in the coefficient, right? And yeah, this does match up completely. So cool. I will see you in the next video.